Hello everyone, welcome to Scorpio Venom Study Games. Before we begin, I want to thank everyone for watching my YouTube channel. Thank you for all the support. And I want to thank all my subscribers for following me on this channel, for believing in what I'm doing. Many of you have many reasons for why you're following this channel. Some of you have some questions related to Unreal Engine. Some of you enjoy my gameplays. Some of you just want to see the process of what I'm doing, and some of you are here just for support. That being said, I have reached over 1,200 subscribers, which is quite a lot of people for me. Return of the favor, I decided to create something special for you guys. Now, this might not apply to all of you, but for those who are into the development of any sorts, I have prepared a gift for you guys. Now, if you have been watching my recent playlist of the world creator 2, I've been designing a island landscape for my game, and what I have decided to do is, in order for me to share that all of you will have access to, and I have created a similar island. Now this one right here doesn't have some of the filters that I've previously created. It doesn't have the crater impact and desert, so this is more of a just vegetative state of the island, so there's no desert on it or anything like that. But what's interesting about this, if I turn the water off, you can see that all the textures are applied through the entire landscape. This is completely randomly generated compared to what I've previously had. I tweaked it a little bit, changed the heights of the landscape and the shape of it. In certain spots it's deeper than in other locations and has a little bit of a different shape. It actually, if I were to turn it back on the waters, you can see that now we have a much larger landscape island over here. And if I were to observe the island, you can see that you have a shoreline over here going all the way around the island up to here. Then we have some cliff formations, little bit of a beach shoreline over here, more cliffs, another beach shoreline over here. If we were to spin around this mountain, you have more cliffs, beach shoreline, a little bit more cliffs, and so on and so on. Now, most of these are just mountains and hills, and what I have here is pretty much a distribution of the textures that have been applied to the landscape. Now, it might not look too much of what you might expect for the landscape texture distribution in certain areas, but the reason that I'm setting this up is because we're going to be using these textures as our layers to set up our foliage. So therefore the position of those are not as bad as that might seem. And there's a lot of things that will be tweaked in the future videos to perfect the view of this landscape. So if you guys are interested in this, you are welcome to download the files that I'm going to share with you, and you will have access to the landscape. And now these files will be only used in the Unreal Engine. So if you are using Unreal Engine, you'll have access to this landscape where it's broken down to 16 raw files, where you'll be able to create 16 levels for your game development or any other cinematics. I figured, you know, you guys can use this for any scenery if you want to. You have some mountains in the background there as well, and also the ocean. And what's interesting about this, you also will get the height maps. Let me go ahead and quickly show you the folder. And it is on my Google Drive. So here we have a free giveaway folder, and I have the heat map for our texture location on that island. I have 13 layers. They all numbered from 01 through 013. And you'll have to download all of them in order for it to properly fill in all the textures. And then what you want to do is download the height maps. Make sure you don't get them confused. The height map is where you'll have 16 of your levels. This is what you want to import into your Unreal Engine. And if you haven't seen the video on how to import the height map into your landscape of Unreal Engine, make sure you check that out. And then from there, I will teach you how to do the rest of the stuff. Now, I haven't uploaded a texture in this folder. If you guys do want me to do that, I can go ahead and upload the folder. Now, it's going to be quite a lot of memory on the textures because they're all 4K resolution. But what you can do instead, if you do follow me on the process that I've taken, all you have to do is just go to the Quixel bridge. And next, what you want to do is go to the surfaces. And then from here, you can choose similar textures that I'm using for the Unreal Engine as well. So when you decide which texture you want to use, just simply download it and then use those textures of your albedo and normal maps to fill in all the information that was given to you guys for the height maps and the heat for the heat maps of all these textures. Now let's go ahead and quickly look a little bit more into this landscape. So you have a transition between the sand and the tropical jungles vegetation over here. I can zoom in so you can get an idea of what textures I'm using. I'm gonna go ahead and zoom in and change to a texture so you can see what I have here. So we have some basic stone gravel. We have a dirt soil, which is in between. This is what you see. And this is what I've replaced that I've previously had the leaves. And they're located right here. And again, what I like about this program is how it blends in certain textures pretty good. Now, of course, there are some things that might need to be done. But other than that, just keep in mind, you'll have mostly foliage covering all these gaps. And again, if you look at these textures, you can find all of these on Quixel Bridge. So we have seaweed that you can download online there as well. Just choose any two that you want to, and you can fill them in. And again, if you've been following me on how to place these textures, you will know the exact layout of it. If not, here is a quick look of it. First one, we have the stone gravel for the tag layer one. The second one is leaves or anything really that you want to use. In this example, I'm using some dirt soil. The third one is the ground stone, which is the formation of all the stones right here in the dark. And again, you can pretty much put any gravel stone that you find fitting for your landscape through the Quixel Bridge. The fourth one is the sand shoreline, which is right here, the fourth one. The fifth one is the sand debris leaves, which is right over, and the name is incorrect because I did change that. This is from the previous one, but it is this grass type right here with some clover. Next one is the grass fig, which is right in front of it, something like this with leaves. You can see some branches and sand in the background. The next one are the cliffs, which is the rock cliff and rock cliff 01 and 03. That is just something that I personally named. But you can find those through the landscape. Let's go ahead and turn on our heat maps. So those are applied mostly underwater. So that way you know this is something that is going to be applied in the ocean. The second one is also an outline over here. You can see a darker part of it. Two mixed variations of the rock formations, and all of these are on the convex of the hills and mountains. Some of those are not too visible because of the weight layer, but we're gonna go ahead and move on to the moss rocky texture, which is right here. And again, you can use anything that you would like. It could be anything. It doesn't even have to be stone formations, but it's set up in a way where pretty much where any of those locations break down for your erosions, it will show up. Now you can't really see too much of it because I applied noise to it to make it a little bit more random and unique. Next one, we have seaweed, which is all the way in the ocean. And if I were to turn the heat maps again, you can see that is just a sand with some seaweed formation. And the last two, we have the green seaweed right here. And then the third one over here. And the reason I've created so few of those is so that way we can use those layers to spawn different seaweed. You don't really have to use those exact ones. You can have another type of sand if you wanted to. And one more layer, which is our ocean floor, is the last one, the 13th layer, which is this one right here with the corals. If I toggle that, you can see that it's applied here. So again, you can use any of the textures that you would like, and that will save you a lot on trying to download this through my Google Drive. You can find any textures that you want, and all you would need for right now is the normal map and the albedo texture from it. And then if we need more, we'll cover that in the future videos. However, now in order for all of it to work, I will be using Brushify Environment Shader Pack. And if you don't have it, I do recommend purchasing this, because this is the way I will be applying all of my materials to the landscape. And I will be going much more into details on how to use it and how we'll be setting up all the foliage and populating our landscape with some vegetation. However, that being said, there is a lot of YouTube videos where you can find on how to create your own landscape materials if you guys do not have access to this project on the Unreal Engine Marketplace. One more thing to keep in mind is that if you are to use this landscape in the Unreal Engine, make sure that when you do import your raw files into your landscape, and we'll cover this in the next video, is that you use your scale Z value at 35.97. I actually covered that in the previous video. So when you do import your raw files, make sure your Z value is scaled to that in order for this landscape to be to the right height, or the exact height as it is in this engine. And here is a quick demonstration of how large this landscape is compared to a third person view perspective. So this is a 2000 by 2000 meters or 2 kilometers squared in size. And then obviously you can expand this as you develop your game or whatever you'll be working on, but you do have a quite large size here that you can work with. A couple spots where you have flat surfaces where you can build bases and whatnot, and then some of the areas that have a little bit more of a slope. And the reason it's dark is because I have clouds formation over there blocking the sun. And then again over here you have a small shallow transition underwater here going all the way to this side of the beach of this island that has cliffs on this side, and then the only way to get to it is pretty much from this part of the beach or over here. But yeah, I hope you guys will find this useful. Again, I will be continuing development, and I figured I'll share a landscape that you can get your hands on and follow along in what I'm doing. So not only that you'll be watching me doing it, but you can also do this with me. And again, the only thing you do need is this landscape itself and the access to Brushify.io. Since I do not have any rights to it, I do own the project, but I can't, unfortunately, share the project with you guys. So I will be using that for the game development, and I definitely recommend getting that. And again, thank you guys all for your support. I hope this is a small beginning of all the cool stuff that I will be sharing with you guys in the future. And thanks again to all of you for all your support. This is something that I always wanted to do, which is the ability to teach you guys and also share some of the things that I have created, and hopefully you'll find a use for it yourself. Again, this takes quite some time to create landscapes like this. So again, there will be other ones in the future that I'll be posting, and of course much, much nicer and better ones. But I figured this will be a good start for you guys to get your hands on if you do not have access to the World Creator, since this program is quite pricey for the beginners to get your hands on game development, things like that. That being said, I will see you guys in the next video, and we will begin adding all these textures to our landscape in the Unreal Engine, and I'll teach you how to do pretty much the rest of the stuff that get involved with Brushify.io and setting up all these grass types and vegetations. I will see you guys in the next video.